service over to Lewis and Laura and allow them a chance to share what Jesus Christ has done in their lives, what today means, what the Lord has done for them. So let's give them a warm welcome as they share their testimony.
There's lots of people here. Some of you have no clue who I am. Some are very, very near and dear and have seen me from birth right the way through to this point. I've got old friends, I've got new friends. So a little bit of a background. I grew up in a church, not this church specifically. My parents were pastors in a church in Scotland, in Dundee. And so, yeah, same fellowship, of course, I guess. So I've grown up in church. From the day I was born, I've been every single service, never missed a service. So, one thing for me that stood out though, growing up, to my parents, the relationship with God was very, very real. I can't really remember a day where I woke up in the morning and didn't see my dad. There he was, sat on his chair, praying, reading his Bible in the morning. And I think they displayed that their relationship with God is very real. And I got to a point where I was like, I want that. I want that relationship with God. I don't want me to just be coming to church, walking into church, leaving church, and still leaving empty. I wanted a relationship with God, which is what something that my parents displayed. I was quite young, I was 10 years old, and I remember it so clearly, even to this day.
And we had a visiting preacher, and to this day, do I remember what he said? No, but at the end, he asked if anybody wanted Jesus to come into their heart, and wanted a real relationship, and I was like, I want that. So I put my hand up, came to the front, and honestly, I was only 10 years old. It's not as if I was coming from a life of sin, but in that moment, I just remember kind of standing up and feeling a peace, a complete peace. Similar really to the peace I feel today, to be honest. And so from there, I just made decisions for righteousness. I knew what the Bible said, I knew what my parents, their exampleship and their testimony, and I just kind of followed along, did what I knew was right, but through it all kept up my relationship with God. And God always made himself very, very real to me, to the point where now I'm standing here. I prayed for this moment. But I prayed that it would be in God's timing, and that's exactly what it is. Because I've got Lewis, my best friend. He really is my best friend, and he really is my other half, my opposite, that completes me. And it's only through my relationship with God that I can testify that I'm standing here. I kept myself. I waited. I didn't rush into anything. I didn't pursue relationships because I knew that in God's timing, the perfect person would come along.
Complete
that that's just who I was. But eventually, again, a few things happened. Got involved in nonsense as you do with the environment that you grow up in. Got involved in the local gangs temporarily. I wasn't the most radical gangster or whatever, but got involved. And I made some very, very stupid decisions at young. Very stupid decisions. But still coming to church, but living a completely different life. Most of you remember me as extremely quiet. I never used to speak. But then outside, I was just doing, having a completely different life. But eventually, I remember in Frinsman Park, I received a phone call from my mum, and she said, "Oh, where are you? Where are you?" I said, "Frinsman Park, I'm coming." And she said that your dad, he's not, he's in hospital. And so I said, "Okay, that's fine." Rushed home. Then he was only in hospital for the space of around a week or two, and he actually passed away. And so for me, that rocked me. Young, loved my dad. Dad done a lot for us. He would do he made sure that we would be in church because he knew that Jesus was here, and he knew that this was the place for us. And so my dad, just a lot of confusion in my own. But eventually, I remember Jonathan brought me to Harmony Hall, a concert in Harmony Hall. And I can't remember what was preached. I can't remember who preached. But I just said, I want to give God a try. I want to give him a try. In my brain, I was convinced. I was like 43 at the age of 12. So I thought, I've done so much. And so I just said, I've tried this and tried that. I've tried this. But I'm going to give God a try. And I did. And it's funny because I prayed a prayer at the altar of Richard Humphreys, actually. I went home and I started looking at my hands and fingertips, and I started appreciating my fingers. And I was like, oh my goodness, God, man. But I was forgiven. I knew I was forgiven. There was something in me. I said, God, you done something. And so, a rocky road, but eventually got here. I really believe it was God that brought me here. I couldn't have done it by myself.
No.
And eventually, for one thing, Lewis Wilkie, these are very important people that were in my life at the time. Lewis Wilkie, Comrade, Harrison Peterkin, Josiah, they were all there in my very lowest point of life when my dad passed away at the actual funeral. And so, at this point, I'm thanking Lewis for marrying his sister. Yeah, God's brought us here. Laura, we can all agree she looks phenomenal.